Yes! Get the fuck in! We are in the semi-finals of the FA Cup for the first time in God knows how long. We're going to be playing at Wembley. Yes! What a performance. Forget who the manager is, because he won't be there next year. No matter what happens at this stage of the season, he will not be there. Alright, so let's end the season on a high. Even if we can't get in the top four, win a trophy. Something we haven't done since Moyes was at the club when he won the Community Shield in his first game. Obviously, the Premier League was the last big trophy. The FA Cup is a big trophy, and I've always said that. I've said I respect it. I just don't want to be a team that consistently is happy with the FA Cup. To be honest, let's stop there. I don't want to slag any other team off, etc. But anyway, I am just so delighted with that game. We played fantastically well, and we've done what we've done so many times under Louis van Gaal. When everyone thinks we're down and out, we somehow pull a performance out of nowhere. We just got trashed 3-0 by Spurs. Completely deserved to be trashed 3-0 by Spurs. And the next game, literally, what, 3 days after? We win 2-1 at West Ham, at their home ground as well, which is obviously their last FA Cup game. But, you know, less of that and more of our win, I suppose, because BBC have already covered all the West Ham stuff, which is fair enough, you know, they're leaving their stadium and all that. But not one person on BBC said we would win today, and that just makes the victory so much sweeter, because we deserved it today. We played fantastically well, even at half-time when we didn't have any goals. Obviously, they said we were doing well, but they said that West Ham would step it up and we'd still win. They had the interviews with, one of the owners of West Ham, and he was fairly sure West Ham, we've seen the best of Manchester United at half-time, and now we'll see the best of West Ham. Didn't really turn out that way. We stayed at the level we did in the first half. In the second half, fair enough, West Ham towards the end of the game when it was 2-0, when they scored, they piled on the pressure as you would expect, but we held out. We did our job. The youngsters were fantastic today. Fosu Mensah again bossing that right back position. Right back, did it? Yeah, it is right back, isn't it? I get confused. Left back, right back. Louis van Gaal plays them all over the park. But anyway, think it was right back today. And he had his toughest challenge yet, and that was Dimitri Payet and Lanzini. And he managed to keep them quiet while still being a threat upfield. And he's only 18. He's only going to get better, and I'm so happy we've got him. At the minute, he's ahead of Rojo and Darmian in the pecking order. Totally deserves it. He's our first team right back, and he should stay there. I know he plays centre back, left back, right back, CDM, whatever, but at the minute, his performances in right back justify him keeping that spot. There's no point changing him if he's doing so well there. Keep him there. Rashford, obviously that goal was exquisite. Martial with 2 assists today. He didn't play amazing, but he didn't put too much wrong, and he got 2 assists, and you know, taking a back step and allowing other players to go, it's nice to see. And Fellaini, for once, played fantastically well. To be honest, Fellaini scored some very important goals. I think he scored the goal that secured us top four last year, and now he scored the goal that secured us a Wembley place this year. So Fellaini, I've got to give credit to him. He wasn't his usual robust self, where he's elbowing everyone in the face, where he's giving away unnecessary fouls. He was actually calm and composed, which is two words I would never think I would use for Marouane Fellaini. But he was deployed more in the number 10 role, more upfield, allowing Carrick to sit back, and it worked, instead of having Fellaini alongside Carrick, where it's so easy to beat them for pace and other things. They were separated today, and Herrera was in that midfield as well, linking things up, so it worked. We had pace on the wings. Lingard played very well. Unfortunately, he missed a couple of chances, but overall his game was great. If he can improve his shooting, he can be a fantastic player. Overall, just a wonderful performance. De Gea made some crucial saves towards the end. Well, let's say one crucial save. The rest of them were fairly easy for a goalkeeper to deal with. But so glad we've got him. Coyote scored an offside goal. oh my God, that was after 2 wonderful saves from De Gea. And it was offside. The officials did a good job today, in my opinion. People may disagree, but there wasn't even too much debate on BBC either. So I'm just delighted. We're playing Everton in the semi-finals of the FA Cup. Let's go and win the damn thing. Wayne Rooney's never won it for us. That is astounding. Last time we've won it is 2004. And yeah, I don't think any of our squad, well, they can't have, no, none of our squad for Manchester United have actually won the FA Cup. So They might have won it for other teams. Like, I don't know if Mata won it at Chelsea, things like that. But they've never won it at Manchester United. So this is the year we need to. And give Louis van Gaal a send-off. At least he's played youth and all that. He's really, really been poor. And he's undone a lot of what he's did in the first season. Because when he does leave, he'll have left us outside the top four in the same position that Moyes did. Maybe in Europa League, so maybe a slight rung-up. But still, he'll leave us with what he started with, which is what you should never do as a manager. But, you know, if he can leave us with a trophy, then at least there's something there. At least there's a little bit of success in his tenure. And obviously, he's played a lot of youth, regardless of how it's happened, injuries and all that. They are the only positives I can see under the Van Gaal reign. If we win the FA Cup, we've still got two games left, getting ahead of myself. But we're in the semi-finals, Wembley. Let's go and win the cup.